All right, I went ahead and started the recording, so I'm going to share my screen and then we'll get started. Just let me know that you can see my actual presentation.
Yep, you're good.
We're good? All right, fantastic. Let me jump right in. Thank you so much for joining me this afternoon. A snowy afternoon, that is, as we work on wrapping up our year and trying to make plans for 2021. Thank you so much for Habitat for Humanity for having me over. I hope to deliver true value and tips and tricks for you guys as well as your patrons as well. My name is Olga St. Pierre. I am a local real estate agent with Keller Williams, and we have been serving clients in New Jersey as well as in PA for now almost going on to 12 years. Our team mission is truly, just a little bit about me, is that we, with help and budgeting, strive to help everyone's dream of owning a home come true. And then once homeowners are there, we help them to be responsible and sustainable homeowners as well. Our community workshops that we do on the regular basis, on the monthly basis, is what is one of my true passions as for the community, is to help everyone understand what's out there on social media, what's on TV, and then make it more of a focus on what matters and what's relevant in our community. So that's what we're here to do. We do have moving services available anywhere in the United States and Canada for your friends, co-workers, and family members as well. And please consider us for our concierge service. We are the virtual Yellow Pages nowadays. So if you need any kind of help, advice, someone to help you take things out from the basement, movers, financial planners, any other professionals, please don't hesitate to reach out to us, because this is what we do and we're here for you. So we're happy to help you with any recommendations. So what are we talking about today? Are the things that we see on HGTV, right? One of our favorite channels on TV. And my goal here today is to help you understand that what you see on TV is completely attainable and reasonable in our reality. And what we're going to talk about today is a couple of little projects to help you make your home just as beautiful as what you see and maybe what you dream of when you see on social media and on TV. So a couple of things that we're going to touch upon today is some of the renovation projects that will bring you the most return on the investment of the money that you put into these projects. Inexpensive tips and tricks that help you plan your staycations, right? There's an actual word like that now, where you may want to stay in your home for your vacations rather than going somewhere else, which is even more relevant now. Best places to shop for some of the amazing things that we share with you, actual before and afters, and some of the new trends that are starting to come out for 2021 in terms of paint, bath, and decor. So that's the game plan for this afternoon. I am jumping right in. The number one thing that you can do that will make a difference in your home is painting, right? Whether you're an old homeowner, whether you are a renter. And you can use paint in two different ways. One is to neutralize, freshen up your walls, as well as making your room look bigger, right? Visually, when you think about it, darker colors make space look smaller. Neutral colors freshen up the space and make it look larger, right? But that doesn't mean that you can't use some of the walls as your accent pieces. I get this question all the time. Well, I don't want bland walls, and that's okay, right? Here are some of the color palette trends that we see in the leading brands that the most of the painters do use is Benjamin Moore and Sherwin-Williams. And when you look at these pictures, it's kind of like they're all over the place. But I think the message here is that you can use neutral colors and you can use some of the walls as accent colors. The pictures that I actually have here in this slide are exactly from the homes that I have visited locally that were for sale. What they've done on the top photo is they took the old paneling that was there in the home that was built in the 60s, and they painted it into a really nice, it's a muted blue, but it's a great accent wall, right? And then what they did is they took the same color and they painted just the entryway. So I kind of encourage you to think about what is it that you can do in your own space. And if you do like color, how can you use it in your own space? here are some great ideas on how you can utilize technology today to try and play around with colors. This actually does not require for you to buy any paint or brushes or do anything. I encourage you to take a picture of whatever room in your home or your apartment that you're planning on experimenting with. You upload it. My favorite program is actually Visualizer from Sherwin-Williams. And then once you upload it into their program, you can paint and try in different things, either with your fingers or right with your mouse, like I'm doing here. It's amazing. It's really great to work with. And it's, I think it's a great start for you to kind of try and see what is it that you want to try and accomplish. Let's jump in some of the weekend projects, right? My goal is to help you see some of the things that you can do very easily, very inexpensively in a matter of a couple of days off that you have, right? So project number one, instead of replacing front door, which you can always do, right? That is always your backup plan. I encourage you to paint it, okay? Just remember that you have to use special paint that is made for exteriors. And I am encouraging you to experiment with bright colors. If you look at these pictures, I actually have clients in France who have this door, and it's more of like a color of sea foam. And every time I pull up to their house, I smile because that door makes me happy. So I encourage you to do the same thing, right? So besides color, you can also experiment with hardware, lighting, and flowers, okay? Very easy to do, a quick weekend project, and it is really going to spruce up your exterior of your home where you live. Project number two, guess what? You don't need any tools for this one, right? If you have garage doors and you want to dress them up, if they're just bland white and you're like, what can I do? You can actually buy magnets and dress up your garage doors. You can buy this household essentials kit. It is right on Amazon. So yes, you have to wait for it to get to you, but you can buy little windows, you can buy hinges, you can buy handles. And because garage doors are metal, it's a magnet, just goes right onto your garage door, just like the magnets that we put on our refrigerator. So give it a shot and it's not expensive at all. Number three and four, again, we're talking about my favorites, which is painting, right? I always suggest to my clients, let's paint first and see how this looks, because the technology has really gone a really long way. And if it doesn't look good, you can always replace it when you have the budget for it, right? So I'm a big proponent of painting kitchen cabinets. There's paints that are available right now from most major manufacturers. And here's a very simple rule of thumb. If you have a small kitchen, go light colors, right? So my favorite is white. White is classic. It does never go out of style. And because white reflects light, your room is going to look bigger. If you have a decent kitchen space and you want to experiment with colors, you can do something really dark like espresso that's in. You can do two different colors, you know, white on top, gray on the bottom, or a different color on the island. And again, take a picture of your kitchen, upload it to that technology and play around with colors and see what really speaks to you. And tip number two is if your cabinets are in good shape, you don't need to paint them, but you still kind of want to spruce them up, either add or update the hardware. You can buy contractors bags of, you know, a bunch of the knobs and pulls right at Home Depot and Lowe's. And if you use the same holes, all it takes is for your child to have a fun project of taking stuff off and then putting brand new knobs on. Project number five, did you guys know that you don't have to replace appliances? You can actually make them stainless steel. This is a great way on the budget for you to turn your appliances that are white and black into stainless steel. You can buy this fake stainless peel and stick contact paper right on Amazon. And I have seen people apply them to anything from dishwashers to refrigerators to range hoods, right? So here are some of the before and after photos. You have to follow instructions. You have to make sure that, you know, there's no bubbles. You have to take your time. But if you prep it just right, I think it looks really, really great. Project number six, here we go again. We're going to be painting. Let's talk about your light fixtures. If some of your light fixtures are a little bit dated and they have some of the gold tones to it, never fear. one of my favorite brands is Rust-Oleum. You can pick it up anywhere from Walmart to Home Depot and Lowe's or online if you don't feel like heading out to the store. And one of my favorites is Paint and Primer in One. This way you just do one or two coats and that's all you have to do. And you can use that paint for interior as well as exterior fixtures. So I encourage you to check out your light fixtures that you have, maybe outside, in your hallways, living rooms, as well as your vanities as well. And look how nice this looks. And of course, they have a million different colors. So that might be the hardest thing that you have to do, is actually figuring out the new color that you want for your light fixtures. Project number 7, we are painting again. Did you guys know that you can actually paint your countertops? Absolutely. After doing some research, I found this Gianni brand right on Amazon. The whole kit comes with everything that you need to paint your countertop. And it's just about $80, which is amazing value versus a couple thousand dollars at least that you would need to invest in buying brand new countertops, right? What I also like about them is number one, they comes with everything in the kit. And number two, look at their colors. Anything from light to completely dark, depending on the color choice of your cabinets, you can play it around. Now, just make sure that your countertop is in good shape, right? That is one important thing, because otherwise once you paint it, you're going to see nicks and dips and so forth, and that might be a waste of your funds. Project number 8. This one does not take any money at all, but it's super fun. I encourage you to, when you go home today or you leave your room to head into the other parts of your home, look and see how your curtains are hanging. And if you ever look at the magazines, I never noticed it before until I actually did worked on this workshop, is that when you look at designers or you look at staged homes or new construction, they always hang curtains, whether it's in different rooms or even in the bathroom, as high as possible towards the ceiling. Because what that does visually, it makes your room look a lot larger. Okay, so general rule of thumb is right here, 10 inches on the top, 13 inches on the side. And the goal is not to frame your window. The goal is to make the window look bigger, right? So give that a try and see which room in your own home that you can try and do this with, right? And these photos are actually from the homes that were for sale in the area that I wanted to show you how high they can hang the curtains. So just be careful when you do that. You have to measure. Now you need longer curtains, right? If you're looking for the curtain length from the top to the floor. Project number 9, let's talk about doors. Who does not like barn doors? They are still in style, right? They have been popular for the few years. And what I love about them is they're so versatile, because you really need something to hang and you need the hardware, which you can buy everywhere. And what you can hang is up to you. If you ever go on Pinterest and you look up barn door styles and materials, I have seen people use pallets. I've seen people use flooring to make barn doors, and all these things look amazing and creative. So I encourage you to see what is it that you may want to redo in your own home. And also, barn doors are great if you don't have a lot of space, right? If you don't have a space to swing the door in and out, that would be a great way to do it. Like for example, I've seen people do it for laundry where they have no room to put swinging doors and the barn door is perfect. Project number 10 is your wall decor. I love this because it is an easy way for you to decorate just about any room in your house. And for pictures and for your collages, first of all, you can buy the collage right on Amazon. I found one that looks great right here. The frames come in different colors and the whole collage is only $35. And what I have found also is actually Restore is a great place to look for frames. Right? Some, you don't have to even have the same colors. Like if you want to have a rustic look, then have frames that are completely different colors and shapes, right? And if you're not sure how to put them together, again, Pinterest to the rescue. Here are some great ideas here for you on how you can put them together, right? Because you can first kind of figure out how to do them on the floor, and then you can put them on your wall. Ideas for what to put in your frames. Number one, if you love taking pictures, we all do, right? Because we all have our phones. You can take pictures of nature or architecture or whatever it is that makes you happy. You can then go to CVS or Walgreens, print those photos. They're very inexpensive, and put them in those collages and every time you walk by them, you're going to truly enjoy them because that is something that's important to you. Of course, you can use pictures of your family, of your pets, anything that's important to you. I encourage you to put in your collage and enjoy it. Project number 11, just a couple more pieces to help you have an amazing home on a budget. If you really like brick walls and shiplap, which is everything's in style right now, but you don't have the funds or you don't want to drag all the stuff into your home, guess what? Amazon still comes to the rescue. There are some peel and stick wallpapers that look like brick and look like shiplap. The good thing about them is you can make an accent wall. You can use them as a backsplash in the kitchen or the bathroom and anything else that you can think of. Right? You can technically use that peel paper as a backdrop for your frame, and then you put the picture in the middle, right? So some of these ideas are on YouTube as well as on Pinterest, so I encourage you to check it out. And this peel and stick paper is removable, and it's clean, right? So you can wipe it if it gets, you know, you get smudges on it or something like that. Next, I'm also going to encourage you to check out some of the decorative window film. When I work with clients, I always see that window film is completely blah and it's very boring. Well, if you look at this one, I found Gloss Window. Again, this is also on Amazon. They have flowers, they have leaves, they have different shapes, and it's just a pleasure to look at. So whether it's something that you want to do for your front door, maybe for your bathroom window, I encourage you just to go one step up from boring and buy something that is fun. Interior project number 12. Let's talk about a couple of other pieces that we can add to our house to make it festive and enjoy it. You can purchase these artificial tropical palm tree leaves right on Amazon, or you can go to Joann's or Michael's. You can put them in any container that you love, and it will decorate any room in your home. A cable channel cover is great if you don't have your TV sitting on the table. You can actually hide the cord in a nice channel, which is paintable, and it's going to make everything look nice, coordinated, and clean. And I always recommend this floating shelf, which you can hang anywhere, in the kitchen, in the bathroom, even in the hallway by your entryway, where you can hang your hats and the dog leashes and your keys. And it's, I believe it's under $20 and it comes with different colors. Number 13, let's touch base upon bathrooms. Here's my suggestions. If you want to do just some small updates, you can, that's very easy to do, and update the handles, just like shown on the photos. If you want to take it one step further, because even small things and small updates can visually enhance and make the room look a lot updated than what it is you can update the faucets as well as the light fixtures. So it is not expensive. This is something you can definitely do in one weekend, and it's going to make your bathroom look and make it feel like almost brand new. Next, I am a big proponent of using some of these tools that, again, I found on Amazon, and you can also find this in Home Depot or Lowe's. If you have small space and you don't have a lot of storage room, utilize everything you have. Hanging over the door shelves for things that you use on a regular basis. You can use these stands with baskets in your bathrooms if you don't have a closet. Back of the door, you can actually hang rods and hang your towels. And these great floating shelves that you can find at Walmart as well, to put some of these simple things that you use on a regular basis. All right, where to buy and for ideas. Number one, our go-to, of course, is Home Depot and Lowe's. We have floor decor in Pennsylvania side. It's in Bucks County, Langhorne. Here in Burlington, it was over in Morristown. It is one of my favorite stores because everything they have there is in stock. So you can go and check everything out. You can touch it and feel it. You can put some of the products together to see if it's going to work, number one, and if it makes sense for what you have in mind. Wayfair is one of my favorite places to shop online. A lot of their products can be shipped for free, and they have tons and tons of colors and ideas. And of course, Overstock, Amazon, eBay. And if you're looking for ideas, House with double Z's and Pinterest are your go-to, where you can probably be buried for months at a time trying to see what are some of the things that really speak to you. All right. So this is my wrap up of all of my suggestions. This workbook will be sent to everyone and with the links to all of our workshops, as well as the recording of this workshop to help you if you want to catch up on something or maybe you missed something. So at this time, I'm going to stop sharing. And I wanted to see, oh, good, perfect timing. If you have any questions or anyone has any questions about anything in particular that maybe I mentioned, or if you want to share some of your tips and tricks, I always welcome that.
Although there were some wonderful tips and tricks and very simple things for our families to do. A lot of those products, not only can you get on Amazon, but you can get at Walmart, which is a wonderful option, and being able to find different things to spruce up a room that you didn't know that you couldn't find that right niche. I'm always one that loves painting and have painted just about every room in the house. Mm-hmm. It's a really easy trick to spruce up a room as you guys get ready to move into your houses.
Absolutely. Paint is your friend for sure.
Yeah. And it's easy to move paint tricks. If you like one wall that's a little darker for like an accent wall, but you're trying to figure out what to paint the rest of the room, stay right in the same color palette, bring it to the first notch for the larger walls, and then the paint chip further down for the accent wall. It really makes Absolutely. The room look spacious too. It's a deception thing for you, your eye.
And if you don't want to try the paint again, try that technology that I mentioned. It's amazing. Like, I had such a fun time, you know, playing around with just some of the pictures. I was like, well, let me just throw my kitchen in there, because you can actually paint the cabinets or whatever color you want, so you can see how it would look if you were to do it in real life. But yeah. To me, the technology that they have available now is amazing to help you make the decisions and the choices.
And PPG Paint actually has a service too, similar to Sherman Williams, but they take it a little step further, and they actually will connect you with the right service agent, and they will recommend paint colors for you. It's actually how I picked the paint color for my ceiling, is from their recommendations.
Absolutely. And a lot of places do have this service is free. You can walk in and talk to some of them, to some of the salespeople, and they will be able to point you in the right direction for sure. Yep.
Does anybody have any questions?
No.
No, it's a lot. So I suggest once you get your workbook, kind of, and I actually cut that workshop, my presentation, in about almost half, because I have more tips, but because I needed to be in a 30-minute slot, I wanted to make sure I gave you the best, the good ones. Awesome. So maybe as you wrap up your year and you want to tackle something small, right? Take a look into consideration as you are, maybe you're at home for a couple of days for the holidays. It's a great time to kind of make some of these plans. Don't make them too grand, because then you never get to them. But if you do a little bit and make some plans and make it more reasonable and achievable, you'll definitely get through it and get it done.
Awesome.
All right. Well, it looks like everybody has all the information that they need. I appreciate you guys having me for this workshop. I hope you found this helpful, and we will send a copy of the recording to everyone, as well as the workbook, and we hope to see everyone again soon, sometime next year.
They were really awesome tips. Thank you.
My pleasure. Everyone stay well, and best wishes for a great holiday season. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.